Hi everyone. So I have a guest today for the SEO career Kickstarter webinar. So we have Mateen Agha, who is associate director for SEO at Bruce Clay, and I'm just looking at his LinkedIn profile. He reports into the regional managing director for Bruce Clay, overseeing all SEO clients across the region from the Dubai office. And I must say here that I got into digital marketing in 2008, and Bruce Clay is actually a name which has been around before that also, right? So it's one of those things which has stayed with me. And I'm so happy to have him as a guest. Hi, Mateen. Would you want to do a quick intro from your side also?
Yeah, definitely, Kaushik. So, hi everyone. So, as you know, Kaushik has already started with an introduction. So, I'm very happy to be a part of this discussion where budding people who are kind of looking for a career in SEO. So happy to kind of add value to this on this front. In terms of, to be honest, SEO for me is something that happened by chance. Back in 2009, after I cleared my engineering, I was looking for a job, and then I bumped into something which sounded interesting, and then I got into it, and then, to be honest, I was never looking back. So yeah, it's been a good 9 years in SEO, which is actually good and bad. Good because I've seen how search engines have kind of evolved, what worked back in 2010 when I started, how it changed the different major algorithms like the Panda and the Penguins, the pigeon updates. That's something that I have kind of lived through. Bad because I'm still in SEO. So yeah, obviously there's a lot more to learn and obviously grow.
Somehow I'm coming across a lot of people of late who have chanced upon the digital marketing industry. It's interesting that you're saying the same thing, that you happen to get into it. I mean, it's the, you know, that's what makes this whole category so exciting, that it is democratic. You know, there is no qualification as such. There is no certification. There's nothing like this. And if you're curious about what is happening on the web, and if you see that, and if you can see that there is enough value for businesses, you know, you and at the core, if you are a marketing kind of a person, I think you would do well, right? So great. Let me just one of the first things that I wanted to bring about early on in this webinar was Google I/O, and one of the interesting things which was discussed there was that what is right now shared. In fact, let me just which is this bit,
yeah.
Right? So Google Search will start indexing podcasts and even let you play them from search. Now let me just, for our viewers, let me just give a quick background that in fact 4 months back Google started making podcasts searchable by automatically transcribing them. So what that means is that if you go to before this, right, you had to go to Google Play and if you search for, say, Lok Sabha elections, right, and then Google would throw up the relevant podcasts for Lok Sabha elections, because it could read the audio, right, because it was transcribing them. But it was only segmented to Google Play, because all the podcasts were indexed and were stored there. For the first time, Sundar Pichai announced that whenever someone is searching on Google at large, so the same looks, you know, same search, Lok Sabha elections, if you go to Google right now and you search, actually this is not yet live in India because it just announced, maybe they're just rolling it out, but the plan is, what Google is saying, that if you search for Lok Sabha election results, about to come in a couple of days, and what, apart from the web results, what is going to happen is that Google is going to index the podcasts also, and it's actually going to allow you to if you see my screen right now, there is this listen tab, right? So you should be able to even listen to the podcasts from Google search. Now as a and I listen to podcasts a lot, and I know that this is a huge thing for people who make podcasts. You know, because for the first time they're going to be accessible to people at large. You know, otherwise, podcasting all said and done is quite niche. You know, it's not mainstream. I think this is going to help podcasters go mainstream. And from the business point of view, what are your thoughts, Mateen? What do you think? Do you already tell your clients that they need to do? Apart from video, you know, or as much as audio as possible, you know, what do you think about this announcement?
So, to be honest, you know, the way I kind of look at this aspect, and you know, it's not surprising where Google is coming up with so much new, with obviously the latest ones being Google being able to automatically transcribe. I wasn't expecting this to happen so quickly, because just the end of last year, when I had a training session with Bruce Clay, we were kind of talking about how on Google transcripts are working. Mm-hmm. And they were actually doing an experiment, which was basically Ask Anything series for Bruce Clay, mm-hmm. wherein at the end of the video, they were including transcripts and it was working fantastically well. And bang, here in maybe like 6 months, we're talking about podcasts being searchable. So I think it's kind of a fairly good thing, because again, this is also somewhere I would want to kind of relate this to voice search. Because mm-hmm. of how things are on that front with voice search on a demand, and it's increasing. And plus, it's also the attention span that you have from users. Now, if you look at statistics, that says that maximum searches happen on a mobile device. Yes. And statistics also say that on mobile devices, your voice searches are just increasing.
Right.
What we kind of understand from this is people are searching on the go. Because no one really is sitting only in the office with their mobile phones in the hand and searching for something. They would rather use their laptop when they have it in front of them. But right. when they are on the go, they would prefer using a mobile device and prefer using a voice search. And at that point in time, nothing could beat the experience if there is actually a podcast that answers the user's query, that's giving them the information that they want.
Right.
Obviously, other benefits that I kind of traditionally, if I want to look at it, other benefits are also people spend a lot of time traveling, mm-hmm. where people are more engaged towards music and YouTube videos. Right. Someone who's actually keen to learn, it could be as simple as SEO, it could be digital marketing, it could be finance as well. If they want to kind of really listen to what's happening out there, mm-hmm. I think that's a very good value add. And you know, I really think of Google as something who's always up at the game, because see, when you look at Google versus anyone else, there's no one close to Google, like still strongholding 90% of the market value. That's a big achievement. That's something very difficult to do. And they are able to do it because they catch the pulse of the people. They know what people wanted, how it will help them, and bang, they do it.
Yeah, I mean, and they really come across as a company which wants to democratize and make their products as accessible to people, right? Whether it is podcasts or voice. So you look at, I mean, in fact, for I think some of you in the audience would have watched the show live, or you would have watched like a summary of it, you would have seen there's so many examples there, a couple of examples where they showed how an Indian woman is reading the menu by using Google Lens, so is able to read something on the ATM using Google Lens. So it's known for making its products more accessible in general, you know. I mean, so it's interesting that Mateen brought out voice search. In fact, that's the next segment, you know, wherein we're going to be talking about preparing for voice search, right? And for that, let's all watch this video where the person is going to be talking about what are the three or four practical things that you need to do on your website with respect to voice search.
And voice search is going to impact the search industry in a very big way. So what it means is that there's going to be longer search queries. So instead of just a couple of keywords typed into Google, people are going to be saying complete statements or asking complete questions instead. There's going to be more questions. Who, what, how, when, and where. Those questions are going to indicate intent. A how question is going to be worth less than a where question. For example, how do I make Thai food versus where can I buy Thai food? Voice search is 3 times more likely to be local, so people are going to be looking for something in their local area. And as the results convert to audio format, it's going to become even more competitive and expensive at the top. So what can you do about it? Well, the first thing is make sure that you have a mobile optimized website. If you don't already have a mobile optimized website, you're already behind. So start there. You want to expand out your search campaign to include the broad match keywords, because people are going to be asking search engines questions and statements in a number of different ways, and you want to appear for all of them. You want to include all the questions that I just spoke about before, the who, what, when, where, and how. And you want to optimize separately because they're going to have separate values across each of them. It's important to be listed in local properties like Google Local and Yelp, because oftentimes people are going to bypass the website completely and just call your business straight from the search results. And from a search engine optimization perspective, you want to start to create the FAQ style content that has both the question and the answer, so that starts appearing as well. So where's it heading in the future? Well, artificial intelligence and technology is becoming stronger every single day. So we can expect in the future that our artificial intelligent assistants, the Siris, the Cortanas, the Alexas, and so on, can start to predict answers even before we ask them. Add to that the Internet of Things, and we'll be controlling our environment through voice. So voice is here to stay. The only question is, are you prepared to adapt?
So, you know, when I was making the notes for this, I there's this thing which I noted down. You know, we are talking about voice search, and in the recent Google I/O conference, in fact, Google is talking about controlling the Google Assistant and the device by gesture. You know, so you know, things have gone that far. But yes, there are a lot of businesses who are still preparing for voice search. So, Mateen, let's just like to get you in here. What do you must be interacting with a lot of businesses in the Middle East and large companies in India also. So what do you think people are, there's a lot of interest, and if there's interest, do you know of some companies who have started preparing, like getting their website voice search friendly?
To be honest, yes. So, you know, when we were working on strategies for 2019, I would kind of refrain from naming any clients out here because of the NDA that we have. However, when we were planning for 2019 strategies, what was kind of different when I compare myself to the India market, where I obviously worked for the largest part in my career, the longest period in my career.
Right.
Is your people expect the strategies to be viewed and, you know, something that's more finalized before the year starts. So one of the key things that the clients did emphasize is there is a lot being spoken about voice search. So they would want to see an element of voice search in the strategies that we have. Right. Now, so what's also very important to look at is things in context. Now, voice search sounds very fancy, is very fancy. And obviously, as I was just mentioning, it's something which is easy to use because of the functionalities that you have.
Right.
Yeah. So in December, I had written a piece for Communicate Middle East the Communicate Online and Middle East. Mm-hmm. Now, what happens is people think voice search. Yes, I want to do voice search. But there are a couple of things that you need to kind of understand, think through, and then decide if voice search is something which is important, you know. So the first thing is, one, very clearly voice search is growing. Mm-hmm. However, but when you look at voice search queries are more when it comes to the local queries, you know. Mm-hmm. So if you compare people actually doing a general search query versus a location-based search query, there are 3x more local queries. Right. So that's an interesting fact, and it's because, again, it's you're driving, you're hungry, and you activate voice search and you say Chinese restaurants near me.
Right.
So near me is also something in the last 2 years has picked up a lot. So that's also one of the key important elements that we consider when we are optimizing websites. And that's primarily because we want to kind of show up on, you know, Google local, maybe a voice search on that front, so on and so forth. Other important things, obviously, is with respect to conversational queries. So, like,
yeah, understanding what... can I actually have a question. Can I just quickly ask it? So, when you're saying optimizing a Google local, so that actually it's just a listing, right? So it's a restaurant listing which is coming up in Google local. So you're saying that also can be optimized for voice search?
Yes, it can be. So, you know, there are different elements therein, which is basically my description that plays a very important role. So that's one thing that really impacts. And the other one, which I really call that as a make or break, is basically the local citations. Your presence in local directories like your Yellow Pages and your Sulekha and Just Dial. So what most SEOs miss out over here is they essentially go out and list out the company in these local directories without maintaining the NAP consistency. So NAP stands for name, address and phone number. So they would have the company name as ABC in one of the listing. In the other one, they would have ABC INC. Or maybe ABC Limited. What they fail to realize is this is a make or break when it comes to local SEO. So coming, you know, mapping this back to it, again, the expectation needs to be correct out here because you would be spoken about or your name will pop up in Google Maps or when you do a voice search only if you are in the vicinity. You know, so when you kind of use keywords, so like I gave an example of Chinese restaurants. So when in your description, when you say, you know, we are a very good Chinese restaurants around Jumeirah Beach Park, or maybe if I would look at a Bombay locality around Bandra West. So when someone is in that vicinity in deep in Bandra West, obviously your mobile phone and obviously Google knows you are in Bandra West. So when you then search for Chinese restaurants near me, it knows you are in Bandra. So it is looking for Chinese restaurants in Bandra West. And that's how the whole cycle works.
Sorry. So you are, I kind of interrupted you earlier when I was talking about, so you are talking about,
So I was talking about then basically when it comes to voice search, how is it different? It's basically conversational queries. So when I talk to my clients and, you know, when this topic came up in our strategy meeting that we should focus on voice search, I had to kind of educate the clients that voice search is, to be honest, not a rocket science. It's about understanding how people search for it. So if I am someone who's searching on a mobile device, rather I'm typing or if I'm using my laptop, I will essentially search for dentist Bandra, for example. However, when I am on my mobile device and doing a voice search, my query will be a complete query like best dentist in Bandra. So it's more conversational, you know, how to find something. How to bake a cake, you know, so it's more conversational queries. So in the strategy, what we had to then do is make sure that when we are talking about content, we also include keywords which were conversational in nature. But most importantly, this is what I advise to all my clients because, you know, a lot of time people whom we talk to, usually the digital marketing managers or maybe the marketing managers also, they want to kind of paint a fancy picture to the management saying, you know, we're doing this XYZ. But what's important for a business to understand is, does voice search really matter in your industry? You know, so if you are someone who wherein this whole concept does not fit in, there's no point force fitting it. So it's important that we agree and understand that, will this really help me? So do we really want to look fancy? Or do we really want to drive people to the website and actually convert them for our business?
I think you're spot on there. You know, one is local businesses because that's, I mean, already you have this surge of voice search happening there. Would you agree that news is something which news and which are the other categories you think are going to be impacted apart from local?
In terms of news, I kind of have a 50-50 thing. because like someone like me as a user, and again it's a personal opinion, may not be applicable to majority, is I would kind of always want to read the short snippets. So someone like me prefers reading news from in shorts, because if there is something that's interesting, then I swipe left and then I'm reading the whole article. So this is completely dependent on the size of the content that I want to consume. If that's something which is short to the point, then yes, very well, that industry will get impacted.
Right.
Now from where I look at it, any local business, you know, let it be restaurants, let it be a dentist or someone who is in the vicinity, they should kind of focus on voice search. And that's primarily because people are searching it that way, like they're driving and they're searching it. So then you should kind of focus on that part. Someone like an agency, you know, like a Bruce Clay or maybe a Learning Catalyst, it's unlikely that someone is driving and then he will search for SEO training courses in Mumbai. It's unlikely that people will do it. So that's where I'm coming from.
Sure. So great. I mean, I think that's you've put the whole hype around this to rest by saying that it really matters for a few categories. Yeah, and you know, the more you read about this, it just comes across that these are very basic, these are basic things which you anyways have to take care of. Like you have to have content which responds to conversational queries, for example. You have to have FAQ kind of content, or you have to have lists. You know, these are things which it anyways makes sense to have it right now. But yeah, for if you're local, then it's a priority. Okay, great. So let's move on to the next segment, where we are going to be we came across this interesting video which was talking about search trends, and we thought it would be interesting to our viewers. So let me just I think it will be good if all of us can watch this video first.
And this data allows us to get a much clearer picture of where people are actually searching today. And the data shows us Google is king, guys. It's not even close. This is 90% of searches happen on Google. This includes Google Images, traditional Google. It includes YouTube. See, these are all Google properties. Look at that. So there's a lot of hysteria around Amazon searches, for example. Amazon product search is real. That's a real phenomenon. But of the overall search pie, everyone else is teensy tiny. Some of you are thinking, well, Sarah, this data is probably old, and it's probably way off trend. I looked at that too. This chart shows over time how search volumes are changing and where are users actually searching using clickstream data. And as you can see, it's remarkably steady. There is no meaningful threat to Google out there, folks. In fact, the number of Google searches continues to increase, and we know they're increasingly mobile. I'm shifting gears a little bit for you. We were just talking about where are people actually searching. Where do you and I search? Now we're shifting gears to where do these platforms send traffic? Where are they sending traffic and how much are they sending? Google is still sending the majority of traffic by far compared to these other platforms. So if you're a marketer out there, you should be deeply curious, who's going to send me the most traffic? It's definitely Google, guys.
Okay. So there are some interesting things discussed here. One of the things which really stands out is the high proportion of image search, which was around 20%, and it's quite a bit. I mean, I wouldn't have imagined, to be honest, that the percentage of image search is that high. Mateen, first of all, do you think that these percentages are justified? Have you seen similar stats of image search being so high?
To be honest, I haven't really seen similar stats in terms of image search growing to this extent. However, at the same time, I'm not even surprised. And this is also something which also sends out a very strong message, especially to SEOs like me, that when you talk about content, content is not nowadays only about text. So we as SEOs, we need to get away from that stigma that when we talk about content, it's only text. It has to be a mix. It needs to be images. It needs to be videos. You know, so a lot of SEOs will debate, oh, yes, but, you know, images are not crawlable. Yes, they're not crawlable. However, your text is helping you rank. Your images is making sure that your users are engaged with your website. You have a higher time on site. You have a lesser bounce rate. These are metrics that definitely impact your search rankings. Maybe not immediately, but within a specific time frame, they do have an impact on whether or not you continue to rank on the first page. So
that's
not surprising to me.
That's correct. I mean, whenever you start talking about SEO with clients, it's just that it's that whole thing of, oh, okay, I have to, you know, put some put a few tags on my text content. Whereas, you know, it's, I think we need to just tell our clients that it's not just about text. It's about making your content assets, whatever it is, you know, more.
It's very simple out there. It's basically, you know, again, it's SEOs. We need to educate our clients, and we need to get away from that stigma. So again, when you say content, we need to also emphasize that this content is going to be for our users. And you would be surprised that video content actually is something that helps. Just I know I'm getting going a little off topic, but then a very interesting thing that I just remembered. So, you know, it's basically Google is, as a company, you know, they have one objective. For users, it's basically like giving what they're looking for. But the internal objective for Google is to make money. No one can shy away from that. So. A lot of things are actually happening in terms of how the search engine ranking page is shaping up and how Google wants to take a higher pie from that. And I'll relate to why I'm talking about this. So, you know, like everyone knows, we always had an inverted L in terms of the paid ads, three ads on the top and then on the right hand side.
Right.
Google one day just came up and said, you know what, we want a standard user experience, both on desktop, mobile. So here I go, I take away all the ads from the right hand side, and we'll only show three ads at the top and at times four. That at times now has become frequently four. So, you know, it's on a mobile device, you literally scroll twice to reach organic. So your CTRs obviously get impacted, but who's making the money? It's Google. Now in the US, they have started something which is called as Google Home Services. So where if you are a local player, so let's say you are a plumber in maybe San Francisco, for example, you can basically subscribe to the service wherein Google will list you right below the paid ads with a tag that says verified by Google.
Okay.
So you have four ads, then you have Google Home Services, which says verified by Google. And it goes to the extent that if you are not happy with the services provided by the vendor, Google will make sure that you get the money back. So now organic is further pushed down.
Yeah.
So you see how Google cannot all of a sudden take away organic, because if they do that, the 90% share that they hold will come down crashing, because then the credibility is in question. So what Google does is it is very slowly nibbling. It's very slowly taking away things from organic. That in mind, now this is again a prediction, it's not something which is official anywhere, but then one of the predictions that Bruce Clay has is the first page of Google organic rankings will have 30% of websites which will have a video on them. So what do you think, when you go to a website and a video plays, what's the first thing that you see?
Well, you are waiting for the video to load.
Apart from the internet.
We are from a geography where that happens a lot.
And the next thing would be?
No, I'm not sure. Okay, sorry. That's what you
mean. It's a YouTube ad, and who makes money? Google, who makes money, right? So Google is trying, it's a theory that Google is trying to push websites to the top positions, which have an ad in that. So, you know, keeping that in mind, what we also did an experiment where we had a website which is related to mouthwash, and we had a video on our YouTube channel, which was basically how to use a mouthwash. We already had a text piece on our website. All we did is we embedded the video on the text piece. So when you go to the page, it basically has a title which says how to use a mouthwash. There's a video which obviously is embedded out there, and then there's textual content. And bang, we are on the first page. We used to hover between the 11th to 15th position somewhere, and we just jumped on to between 6th to 8th position. Although down on the first page, but we are out there.
Okay, yeah, so, that's interesting. But this is only if you are talking about YouTube videos which are embedded on your website, right? For a moment, I thought you were talking about the homepage video. This is just talking about YouTube videos here.
YouTube videos wherever they fit onto your website. That's what I was kind of referring.
Sure. So as of now, you're saying the percentage that you mentioned, 30%, that's something which you're seeing right now, or
no, it's a prediction. It's a theory.
Okay, a
prediction that this is how it will kind of turn out to be, and obviously it's with the intent of Google trying to make more and more money.
Sure. I mean, so that's like further incentive for all businesses to make videos, because if they make it and embed it on their pages will get discovered, you know. That's interesting. I mean, image search is growing, whether or not all of us agree with 20% is a different thing, but the fact is it is substantial, and we need to pay more attention to non-text content assets. The other thing is interesting, I mean, YouTube, Amazon is picking up. I think that's because of the number of people who have started to use Amazon and started searching for products. I mean, so if you are a e-commerce business, then you have to pay attention to SEO aspects on your listing on Amazon, because it is a huge search pie. So great. I think
I have something to add over here in terms of, you know, the search queries. Again, a lot of things, you know, even the video that is being played, it also talks about, you know, is SEO actually dead? And then it talks about how it's not actually dead, because Google is still holding 90%, more than that. So it's something, and if you aggregate it, it actually drives 60% of the traffic to your website. Through paid, through organic is a different conversation, but the searches happen over there. So statistically, if you actually look at the number of searches happening, you know, a couple of factors that I would want, because there are misconceptions in the market. So people are heavily focused saying that, you know, mobile traffic is increasing. But what they don't understand and what they do not look at is mobile traffic is increasing, which means you have around 60 to 70% of traffic coming from mobile on your website. Right. But an interesting fact is searches on desktop are also increasing. However, it's just that the growth rate is fairly slow, and is why that's not really something that's being talked upon. So when we are into this industry, we should kind of, while we, you know, the outer things is something that you should look at, but you should also look at the under the carpet things of whether or not should you focus on desktop or should you move it completely. You know, so that's one thing I would really want to bring up. Second is, again, in terms of the searches happening on Google. So a lot of times, you know, the clients, usually they ask this particular question is whenever they search for something, and especially when it's a product related search, it's actually e-commerce websites that dominate. So where do the brand websites then stand a chance? How do you optimize brand websites so that they are able to rank for their own product queries? So here, again, you need to kind of understand is Google works on the information that's collected by RankBrain. Okay. In a nutshell, RankBrain is something that kind of has been observing that when people search for a particular type of query, do they click on websites which have information, or do they click on websites which have the product, which means it's a transactional website. That's your e-commerce website. So RankBrain is there. You cannot challenge RankBrain. But what's interesting to know is out of all the searches that are happening on Google, 90% of the searches are actually informational queries. This is where brand websites have the opportunity to show up. you know, because people are searching more for information.
The 90% of the, sorry, what you mean is 90% of the market, which is the 90% of what? Is the e-commerce market or?
All search queries.
All search queries.
If there are 100 searches happening, 90 searches are actually about finding some information.
Right.
The remaining 10% is for finding a product.
Right.
And out of this, so out of that remaining 10%, Amazon ranks for 50% of those queries. So that's kind of, sure. that's the kind of share that Amazon has. And obviously sure. they are just growing larger by the day, even in the Middle East market. So it used to be Souq that got acquired by Amazon. And maybe just last week or 2 weeks back, they changed from Souq.com to Amazon.ae.
Oh, okay.
So, yeah. So that's an interesting thing. And they're going very aggressive out in this market. So something that is a threat to a lot of e-commerce players in this market. But just to sum up why I spoke about all of this is a lot of time these queries will come your way that e-commerce websites actually rank for most of the terms. So what should we as brand websites really do? You know, so information queries is what is you need to focus on.
Sure. And then there is a lot of scope there, you know.
Definitely. As I said, it's 90% of the queries are informational. So that's where you can kind of see these are going to be long tail queries, you know, so you will have the queries, but more in number, obviously, which will then have more search volume. So it's basically your strategy that needs to include that we need to kind of target informational queries, add content accordingly, and then hit it out.
Right. Great.
Yeah.
Great. So I think we've covered all the aspects that we wanted to discuss in the webinar. I mean, it was a good discussion. I think we covered voice search pretty well, and also the other bits about the indexing of podcasts and all. So great. I'd like to thank Mateen for his time. And I hope to have him as a guest for some other webinars in the future also. So thank you, Mateen, for your time.
Yeah, most welcome. I was glad to be a part of this. And yeah, definitely look forward for more webinars together.
Great. Thanks, Mateen. Cool. Bye.
Thank you, Kaushik. Yeah, have a great day. Bye.
Yeah, same to you. Bye.